Good afternoon, everyone. Cassandra, I'm back again. This time I'm going to talk about sleep. I know I said that I was going to come back a couple of days ago, but I'm working on a couple of books, and I got caught up in the writing, and those of us who write knows that when those thoughts are flowing, you have to go with the flow. I'm not using it as an excuse, but it is the reason why I didn't get the video out like I said I would. I apologize for that. I try to keep my word, but I got to writing and I forgot. So sorry about that, but I'm here to try to get that information out to you. Well, today I got up this morning. I did my workout, 40 minutes. It was easy, but 40 minutes of my handball, I mean. And it was very easy, and it was peaceful. We should try to do things that are peaceful. You know, sometimes things might get hectic, but when things that you can control, like you're working out or you're sleeping or you're eating, it should be peaceful. Eating should be peaceful to your body, meaning not hard to digest foods that are easy to digest. Drinking your 42 ounces of water, good water, or resting, laying down, resting. So what we're after peace. We're trying to get our organs in our body peaceful. The way we do that is to get them healthy. So we partly by sleeping, eating, and exercising. Those three things can help us balance and become peaceful on the inside. And you will notice that your thoughts will be peaceful, and your body will talk to you and tell you what it needs when it needs it. So we have to clear out all the goobity gump so we can actually see and hear our body when it's talking. Now, another thing that I wanted to mention is that my stomach is whittling away, guys. The fat that was on my stomach, I swear to you, I never thought that I would see the fat that was around my stomach that led to the rolls in my back and my back and my butt touching. I never thought that I would see that leave. But it is definitely leaving. My stomach is definitely whittling away. And I owe it to the handball that I'm playing. I didn't see the results until I started playing the handball. It only took me a month. This is my fourth week here of seeing results. It did not take long playing the handball. So those of you who have not tried it, try it to see if you like it. And if you don't like it first start, keep it up for a little while longer. Maybe you might grow to like it. Or if not, find an exercise that your body responds to well, as I said in my other video, and then do that. But try the handball. That's the only thing that worked for me. I tried the running. I tried the walking, which walking is good. But you have to calculate the amount of walking you need in order to see the results. Now, walking is the best form of exercise. But just like I said, I'm in a new neighborhood, and I don't want to be out in a neighborhood that I don't know anything about. Once I've learned the neighborhood, then I'll probably start walking. But the handball has worked for me. And I did it today. I did it Monday. I did handball Monday, and I didn't do it Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or yesterday, but I did it this morning. So I don't do it every day. Just like I said, when you're overweight, you really don't have to do that every day. You need to skip some days so your body can utilize that fat that you have, burn it. so get rid of it. But that exercising every day, you really don't have to do that. But if you want to do that, it probably maybe take you a little longer to drop those inches, which are so important. But if you do it, if you stagnate it, like stage it, I mean, step it like I'm doing, one day on, one day off, 2 days on, 2 days off. If you do it like that, the results are very much immediately, and you'll be happy that you did. Now, on to what I was talking about when it comes to sleep. There are two stages to sleep. The first stage is your restorative, meaning it's repairing your body. The second stage is you are resting, which is when you're supposed to take your blood pressure when you wake up in the morning, because that's called your resting blood pressure, to see what your blood pressure is. So when you are getting into bed and to get the restorative sleep, you really need to be sleep between 8 and 8:30. So by the time 8:39 roll around, you should be in good sleep. You're going to have to work on it. It wasn't easy for me to do it. I had a real ugly habit of, I liked getting in the bed with my tablet and just playing games, watching videos, maybe working on my book, or different things like that. But I started feeling really, really bad. Really bad. My head was swimming. My legs were hurting. I was in bad shape. And I knew that I needed sleep. So what I did was, which was a struggle, guys, I'm telling you, this is what got me really. I'm learning how not to judge people, because who would have thought going to sleep would have been such a struggle for me? Now, it may not be a struggle for you or others that are listening to this video, but for me, it was a struggle. I struggled with putting that tablet down and going to sleep. So, but the feeling got so bad that I was like, I got to go to sleep. And I still was struggling. Even though I knew I would get up the next day and I was going to feel lousy, I still had a hard time, guys. You know, you wonder like, dang, why don't he or she push that plate away? Why don't they do it? Don't judge people, I'm telling you, because that struggle is real, and it might not be real in your world or your life, but for somebody else, it is. And I had a hard time going to sleep. Now, I'm getting closer to 8 o'clock than 8:30. 8:30, I usually shut things down. I don't care what's going on. I shut it down. But now I want to push it to 8. I want to push it to 8 so by 8:30 I can be asleep. So sleeping from, I think it's when the sun goes down. It depends on where you are. You should be asleep by the time the sun goes down, because they said that that belt flips. So when that belt flips, when that sun goes down, you should be in the bed asleep. You're going to sleep from whatever time you go to sleep. Maybe you might wake up before, because I used to. I don't know, you know, I'm going through another stage right now. But I sleep, my body's restoring, repairing itself, because I feel so much better. Even though I was exercising and I call myself going to sleep, I still wasn't feeling good like I wanted to. I wasn't to where I wanted to be. So I said, I'm going to have to go to bed earlier so I could energize my adrenals. Get my adrenals cleaned, get them energized so I can feel better. So that's what I was working on, guys. So I go to sleep. I worked my way up to about 8:10, 8:15. Still trying to get to 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock to 12, that's restorative. you got anything that's going on with your body, your mind is going to send the medicine that it needs, that your body needs, to repair what is going on wrong. If you are eating properly and exercising, it all goes together. You can't do one without the other. It's just not gonna work, okay? That the eating the fried foods, eating the pork, I'm not judging, I'm just saying. Drinking the sodas, drinking these sweet artificial juices, that's not gonna work. Processed foods, that's not gonna work. You have to clean your diet up. The next video I'll do is I'll talk about cleaning your diet up. But get rid of the processed foods. Get in the bed early. Sleep. Restore from 7 until 12. And then anything after 12 that's going into the morning hours, that is resting. Now you are resting because your body has spent half the night, if you've gone to bed at a good hour, where it has like 3-4 hours, maybe 5-6 to repair, then the other 6 or 5 are for resting, and you will find that you are feeling better. Now I know that you can go and study into sleep a little bit better, but I just simplified it because all the rapid eye movement and all that, okay, I'm not discounting that. I'm not saying anybody is wrong. I'm just telling you what I have found out and what I've studied. You rest from 7 to 12. You restore from 7 to 12, from 12 to about 5. Your eyes should be popping open on their own. Mine do. My eyes pop open around 4:30. My body's like, okay, hey, I got enough rest. If your eyes are not popping open, then, okay, work on that. Get them to start opening on their own. But that's what I wanted to share with you all. I was talking to a young man the other day. I got to find out what his webpage is. YouTube. So you guys can go and listen to him. He's very, very knowledgeable on a lot of things. And he talks about breathing properly. Breathing helps to energize your cells, clean your cells, helps you to feel better, helps your blood pressure, regulate your blood pressure. And I was telling him how low my blood pressure was. It was like 109 over 60. And I was telling him about it. And he's like, wow, those are young person's numbers. And I didn't even know. I thought it was too low, to be honest with you. But my body is responding positively. And my body is at peace. One thing I do want to tell you is that if you start playing the handball, you should at least play the handball until you break out in a sweat and that your nose starts running. That way you know that you are detoxing. If you're not doing that, then keep it up. Keep it up until it starts, because you're doing something new that your body is not used to. So if you have any questions, guys, let me know down in the comments. Please like and share this video. Talk to your friends about this video. Please help support my books. You can find them on Amazon, Picture Perfect Health. I have 2 books. One is called The Reader. The other one is a workbook. And I also do stories. So I have a Patreon that is, it's Apply Knowledge. That's the name of it, Apply Knowledge. But if you go to start following me on Instagram, I'll try to put a lot of these links in the comment section, but in the description section. But I am Yo Girl May on Instagram. Follow me there. The link for my Patreon is on there, and you can follow me with my stories. But the Picture Perfect Health books, those are for weight loss purposes. So that's it, everybody. I'm going to say goodbye for now, and we will talk again. Have a great day. Bye.